At the outset, as a media art specialist and podcaster practitioner, I use colors on a daily basis to communicate. What captivated my attention about colors is its tartness and beauty that constitute any environment and beyond. For example, when I look through the window in my study, I am in awe at the fact that the array and how the varying hues, tones, and shades of colors that affect, comport, and complement the lawn and the trees. This picture is not a myth nor virtual reality, but expresses the authenticity to the importance of color in my life and presumably all global citizens. The aforementioned paragraph is the point that frames the parallel for this intellectual conversation, namely the shades of a global culture, which are employed as a pretext to answer the philosophical, figuratively, symbolically question in context. Are children our cultural heritage? In this space, it is important that we observe the definition hue, which is deemed a term that seems more complicated than it is. A hue is just a color. More specifically, a hue is any color on the color wheel. There are three primary colors, red, blue, and yellow. Most of us also know that combining any two of these primary colors will give you one of the secondary colors. Red and blue make violet, yellow and blue make green, and red and yellow make orange. A third set of colors, the tertiary colors, fill in the six gaps between the primary and the secondary colors: red, orange, blue, green, red, violet, and so on. Tertiary colors are pretty simple to figure out based on their names, so we won't cover them here. Colors on exact opposite of the color wheel are known as complementary colors. Mixing a color with its complement will give you a muddy brown. You might have noticed that black and white are not colors on the color wheel and thus are not hues. So where do they fit in when it comes to mixing colors? Tints, tones, and shades are variations of the hues found on the basic color wheel when white, black, or both are mixed in. The cultural coach, workshop facilitator, and writer of a weekly advice column, Linda S. Wallace, espoused the view that there are tints in culture. Think of it this way. When race is involved, most of us are wearing cultural shades. These lenses are filters or shaped by information we keep in our libraries of experience. A close-up view of Wallace's view imputes that traditionally, all global citizens, regardless of our identity, consciously and intuitively use their cultural lens figuratively, metaphorically, philosophically, and symbolically to enunciate our testimony within shades of a global cultural space. Undoubtedly, there is a perception that cultural heritage is an expression of the ways of living as developed by a community and passed on from generation to generation. The same includes customs, practices, places, objects, artistic expression, and values, which can be characterized as an infectious nuance. In this context, shades of a global culture have always occupied the annals of history, pre-BC, and will continue post-AD. Cultural heritage is either intangible or tangible nuance. Cultural heritage produces tangible representations of the value systems, beliefs, traditions, and lifestyles, which are also an essential part of culture as a whole, underscoring visible and tangible traces from antiquity to the recent past. Cultural heritage is also described as a wide concept. Heritage encompasses a broad and overarching term. It is something that someone or a collective considers to be worthy of being valued, preserved, catalogued, exhibited, restored, and admired. For example, the Central European University's Cultural Heritage Studies program describes cultural heritage as the legacy of physical artifacts, cultural property, and intangible attributes of a group or society inherited from the past generations, maintained in the present, and bestowed for the benefit of future generations. This discussion certainly evokes some analysis because culture is learned, communicated, preserved, and transmitted culturally. It also stirred up an intellectual consciousness within my mind and presumably the mind of global citizens, figuratively, philosophically, symbolically, and theoretically. Of note, the information collected in this podcast is an analysis which was examined through my cultural lens as an author and media arts specialist and licensed cultural practitioner. This information assisted me to appreciate the fact that humans and culture are inextricably linked within their cultural geographical space. Finally, this conversation, The Shades of a Global Culture, was employed as a pretext to draw our attention to the reality that figuratively, philosophically, and symbolically in context, our children are our cultural heritage. Therefore, cultural heritage is not only an expression of the ways of living developed by a community, but are passed on from generation to generation, such as artistic expression, customs, practices, places, objects, and values, which are an infectious nuance that have been occupying the precincts of history pre-BC and will continue post-AD in the shades of a global cultural space. In ISBN 978-976-96-220-74.